again, everybody. We're back, and today we have a process art project. I know, it's hard to tell that something like this might be art, but it is creative. And we are theming this off our book, Half Magic, and I'll explain how that works in just a minute, because what we're doing, and Evelyn just asked me a question. What was the question?
How does bubbles compare to half magic?
So how are we tying in the theme of half magic to bubbles? Well, first of all, it's kind of a windy day, so it's a good day for bubbles, right? Second of all, these bubbles are half magic and half science.
Not half magic.
Aren't bubbles kind of magical, though?
Yeah. Like, how do
they float? I think they're magical. Exactly. How do they float? How is there always a
rainbow?
Because
it's filled with gas.
Okay.
And gas floats.
Okay. How is there always a rainbow?
Yeah, but how does gas float?
Why are they always round?
No, it's filled with air, and air is everywhere. So.
Yeah, but air doesn't exactly float. It's like kind of like just
air
like
is
floats.
In this bowl. So.
Okay, well, we have a lot of ideas. Yeah. And the other thing we're going to do is make bubble snakes today. So I'm going to show you something really amazing that's about to happen. And what you guys can do is tell your mothers or grandmothers or aunties to get out a pair of old stockings and cut little squares. And then you can get an old toilet paper roll, but we think toilet paper rolls are kind of gross.
So I got old
paper towel rolls and cut them in half. So you get nylon stockings, cut squares, paper towel rolls, and rubber bands. You're going to see how this works in a minute. So to make the bubble solution,
a hummingbird.
You need 2 cups of water. Yes, 2 cups of water, a cup of dish detergent. We kind of like the cheap one you can get from Home Depot. So try that one. And the other thing in the recipe is to do 1 tablespoon of glycerin, but we don't have glycerin, so we made a simple syrup. To make simple syrup, you need half sugar, half water, boiled up and stirred together. So whatever your measurement is, if you want to do a cup of water, you need to do a cup of sugar and boil it and mix it up. So that's our replacement for glycerin.
Too.
2 tablespoons of simple syrup. So, into our 2 cups of water, Evelyn is going to go our dish soap. And we might need to use our spoon a little bit to get some more of it out, because we need as much of that as possible.
This is like a YouTube video.
Stop licking the simple syrup, Charlotte.
But it's so yummy!
Okay, and then our next is going to be our simple syrup. 2 tablespoons of simple syrup. The simple syrup will help bind the soap and the water together to make better bubbles. Yes, we'll use stir, please. Not too rough, because then it'll bubble all up and it won't work. So just a little stir. Okay, gross.
It's yummy.
Okay, Evie, I think we're done.
You guys will like it.
Okay, now we are going to take our crazy invention here, stick it in. Let the soap soak a little bit. You have to really blow. Whoa, Charlotte! I'm not getting much of a snake, are you? Yeah, he's getting a snake. Oh, there's my snake.
Mine's like a butt. Uh-oh, the butt is falling away.
Camera Man Mikey gets to try. And that's the end. Thanks for stopping by again.
Hey, stop.
We hope to see you soon.